The executive director of the Port Authority, who handles the trains and the buses, has now tested positive for coronavirus. And now a 7-year-old girl in the city. We have news on her condition tonight. And a physician's assistant who says he believes he was infected at a conference held in Times Square. He's 32, no underlying conditions, and what he's experiencing tonight. And in Washington state, the death toll rising. They are now in the middle of a nursing home crisis. ABC's Whit Johnson on the states of emergency unfolding across this country tonight.
Tonight, New York State reeling from the largest coronavirus outbreak in the country. The number of cases, at least 140, and climbing. The nation's busiest transportation hub taking another hit. Physician's assistant James Kai says he got the virus after attending a medical conference near Times Square. He's 32 with no underlying conditions.
They are surprised it can be that bad so quickly, and I'm so young. I don't drink, I don't smoke.
Kai says his health is deteriorating. He's hospitalized in New Jersey.
Half of my lung is already pneumonia, not working, only half. So I don't know how much longer I have.
Rick Cotton, the executive director of the Port Authority, now the state's first public official to test positive. The agency saying he's asymptomatic and has self-quarantined at his home. A 7-year-old girl in the Bronx also testing positive, the youngest known case in the U.S., said to be doing well with her family. But New York's most volatile flare of community spread is in Westchester County, with the majority of the state's cases.
This is the hot spot, one of the hot spots nationally.
Officials say dozens of cases trace back to one man, a sickened attorney named Lawrence Garbus, whose case was complicated by a previous condition. His wife, who is also infected along with their two children, saying the rest of the family is in good condition and that her husband remains critical, but she is very hopeful of his full recovery. That case resulting in a wave of school closures throughout the county. Multiple universities in the state, including Columbia, Hofstra, and Fordham, also canceling classes. New York City's mayor suggesting dramatic steps to keep the elderly safe.
Even if you love your grandchildren, for example, you don't want to go see your grandchildren if they happen to be sick, even with a common cold. You just don't want to do it.
In Washington, D.C., several hundred people ordered to self-quarantine after some received communion from Reverend Timothy Cole, the leader of a prominent Episcopal church who became the city's first confirmed case. Hard-hit Washington state now has infections in at least 3 different nursing homes. It's the deadly epicenter, with at least 22 fatalities, 3 more announced today from that life care nursing facility.
We've had patients who, within an hour's time, show no symptoms to going to acute symptoms and being transferred to the hospital. And we've had patients die relatively quickly.
So let's get to Whit Johnson. He's live from the hospital where that attorney is being treated. We know, as you reported, Whit, in critical but stable condition. He had that underlying condition from what he had gone through before. You were reporting tonight that the mayor of New York is now telling people to be prepared for hundreds more cases in the coming days and weeks.
David, the mayor says that as they ramp up testing, they are preparing for a spike in cases here. Officials making the point that if you look for something, you will find it. And tonight, the FDNY confirming its first positive test of a New York City EMS worker. David.
All right, Whit Johnson on the story here across the country. Whit, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.